Don't be the guy who walks into the office of Joe Pometto Law, sits down with me, his attorney, and tells me he has a speeding ticket. I look at the ticket, all right, and it's not just a speeding ticket. He's charged with reckless driving, careless driving, speeding, not obeying stop signs, not pulling over fast enough, etc., etc., a whole laundry list of charges, when the only thing he was doing wrong was speeding. You don't want to be that guy. And today, I'm going to give you 3 tips on how to deal with a speeding ticket. But before we dig in, I want you to like, subscribe, and share this video. The reason that I'm asking is because I enjoy making these videos, and if you like, subscribe, and share these videos, YouTube will reward me. They'll give me a higher search ranking, okay? And that incentivizes me to keep making more videos. Now let's get down to 3 tips on how to react when pulled over for speeding. I'm gonna summarize those 3 tips right here. Number 1, you wanna pull over as soon as possible. Number 2, be polite. And number 3, plead not guilty. Let's talk about number 1, pulling over as soon as possible. You're driving down the highway, boom, the police lights go on behind you. Maybe they give you a whoop whoop or a little bit of the siren. Okay, you start to get nervous. You say, what do I do? Where do I pull over? All right, and you keep on driving and you keep on going, and then you come to a light and there's traffic around you, and all of a sudden the officer's still behind you. Now he's putting his siren on all the way. The light turns green. You're more nervous. You keep driving. You're on a highway. Okay, you go. Next thing you know, you're a half mile away before you pull over, and there's 3 cop cars on your tail. You don't want that to happen to you. My advice is pull over as soon as you can. Now, you do want to be safe about where you pull over, all right? But the officer should be thinking about that, and they usually are, whenever they put their lights on you, all right? So that they know they're in a place where you'll have some room on the shoulder of the road to pull over. Now, that's not always the case, all right? If you need to drive maybe a quarter mile or less than a quarter mile, what you want to do is you want to slow down to acknowledge that you know that you're supposed to pull over and the officer's on you, and you want to find the best place possible. But if you can't, pull over on the shoulder of the road, all right, and don't drive too far. The reason I give you this advice is because I've had clients who were charged with fleeing and eluding when they came and they told me that they were just looking for a better place to pull over. Now, I don't know if that's true or if that's false, but I've heard it a couple of times. If you go too far, all right, the officer's going to get annoyed with you. All right, it's their job to pull you over in a nice, safe place. And if you're going to drive maybe an eighth of a mile to find a good spot, all right, that's advisable, but don't play that game too long. It could be perceived as you attempting to flee. So pull over as soon as possible. Tip number 1. Tip number 2. This is the most important tip. Be polite. I can't tell you how many times I've represented clients on traffic tickets or traffic violations, all right? And I walk in, and like I told you at the beginning, my client has a laundry list of violations. And I say to the officer, what's going on here? All these laundry list violations, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. They look at me and they go, your client was a jerk. Usually their language is not that nice, okay? They say something even meaner about my client, all right? Sometimes they'll tell me the mean things that my client said to them. So what does that officer do? He pulls out every offense in the code book that he can slap on your client, all right? So if that individual was nice, might have walked in with 1 charge, a speeding charge. But because he got into it with the officer, he's got 5 or 6 or 7. On top of that, when we walk into that hearing and we're trying to make a deal, the officer's 10 times more likely to make a deal and reduce the speeding amount or drop some of those other charges if the client was nice. Sometimes that's all they want. You need to be polite. You need to answer the officer's questions and comply. Now, I know that in some situations, you got to be very careful about what you say, okay, to an officer. You can watch my last video, Stopped by the Police, 3 tips, all right? But in the case of a speeding ticket, have a conversation. Be nice, be polite, answer all the officer's questions, all right, in regards to speeding. Because, you know, again, if you're polite about it, it's probably something that can be taken care of. All right, whenever you go and you hire an attorney and you go there. If my clients are really polite, the officer say, I'll give them no points and pay a small fine. And that's beautiful, but it all depends on that interaction, all right? And if you're not gonna answer questions, which is sometimes the best thing to do, watch my last video, you need to be extremely, extremely polite about it. Tip number 3, plead not guilty. This is another common thing that I see with some of my traffic clients is they call me up. They say, Attorney Joe, I paid the ticket and now my license is suspended. I said, that's because when you paid that ticket, you pled guilty. Paying the ticket is a guilty plea. You're saying you did the crime. You did the traffic offense. You may not know what kind of penalty that comes. Yeah, it might be $100, $50 fine, $150, but it could come with a license suspension or points on your license, all right? You have nothing to lose by pleading not guilty. Plead not guilty, go to a hearing, then you can talk to the judge and the officer, all right? They can tell you what you're looking at, and most of the time, like I said, if you were polite during the stop, they might make you a deal, and you can walk out of there with a very good deal. All right. So never, never, never just plead guilty. If you thinking maybe that's something you really want to do, pick up the phone, call Joe Pometo Law and ask me, say, Joe, I got this ticket. Does this come with a license suspension? Does this come with points? Am I going to have to take a class if I pay this ticket? All right. This is why I am here. This is what lawyers get paid to do. I'll give you a 10, 15 minute conversation over that, no charge. Absolutely, all right? If the best advice to you is, hey, oh, this ticket, this doesn't carry any points or a suspension, I might tell them, go ahead, you can pay it if you want. You can plead not guilty, go to a hearing, you might even get it dismissed. If you were polite, if you show up, take some of my tips from the last video, dress nice, all right? Addressing the officer and the court with respect. So pick up the phone before you pay a ticket, call Joe Pometo Law, call attorney. When in doubt, plead not guilty, then buy some time, then call your lawyer. Call me, all right? And I'll help you get it taken care of. So those are my 3 tips on how to react and what to do when you've been pulled over for speeding. It's a little different than what I put in my Stop by the Police video, okay? But it actually isn't, because no matter how you deal with the police, either in that last scenario or this scenario, where you need to be polite, if you're not giving them information, if you're cooperating, no matter what, be nice, be polite, all right? It's not that difficult to do, and it's always going to pay off for you in the end. So I hope you enjoyed this video, the 3 tips, one more time. Pull over as soon as possible so that you're not perceived to be fleeing. You don't cause the officer to call more backup, all right? You don't want to end up with guns drawn on you. So pull over as soon as possible, maybe an eighth of a mile, a little bit less. Number 2, always be polite. It's going to work for you in the long run. And number 3, plead not guilty. On top of all of that is call your attorney, call Joe Pometo Law as soon as possible. If you like this video, subscribe, like, and share. It gives me some juice with YouTube. It incentivizes me to make more videos. It lets me know that you guys are watching and you're enjoying my videos. Also, leave a comment. If you leave a comment about you want me to discuss a certain topic, I'll look it up, I'll come back on, and we'll talk about it. This is Joe Pometo Law signing off. Thank you.